Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where we talk about skincare, grooming, and sometimes hair, so that sounds like your thing. Make sure you are subscribed. Also, come and follow me on Instagram where I post a lot of stuff you're not going to see here on YouTube. I would say TikTok as well, but I never really post on TikTok. I'm kind of more on there to spy, see what the kids are up to, check on the kids. And today we're going to be checking up on a few of these videos. There are some atrocious skincare videos on TikTok. Never from creators. There are some amazing skincare creators on TikTok, but some profiles are on TikTok to sell product and they're horrific. So there's this certain genre of profile and video basically where these big companies bulk buy cheap skincare from the internet and sell it on to us. Then they post these super fake videos of their products performing these skincare miracles that in my opinion look so shit and so fake, it's unbelievable. So today I'm going to show you these videos, debunk these videos, then give you an idea of what could actually work instead of these cheap shitty products that are probably going to burn your skin off. So let's take a look at this video. This is peel off post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. So this is one of my favorites because I feel like it's semi-believable. You look at this mask and you think, oh wow, that's actually performing miracles. So in this video, we just see a peel off mask being lifted from this lady's face. Her skin is like pretty amazing underneath. A normal peel off mask is lifting away dark spots, post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, or even freckles. A lot of these pages sell products to remove freckles, which I don't understand why, because freckles are so nice. So this one is super easy to replicate because it is of course fake. You apply a peel off mask, you let it dry down on the skin, you then draw freckles, post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation over the mask using something like an eyeliner. I don't have makeup. I do have this eyebrow drawing tool though, so I'm gonna draw it on with this, given the effect that you're literally lifting away a layer of skin. Post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation goes deeper than that first layer of skin. It's not something that's sitting on top of your skin that can be scrubbed away. So a peel off mask like this is absolutely impossible. There are, however, of course, things like chemical peels that over time can get rid of blemishes, dark spots, all that kind of stuff. But this is done at a professional level, not at home using a peel off mask. This does of course look like somebody's doing a professional treatment on this lady. It's probably just they're filming it in their kitchen, you know. I have checked to see if there's anything like this on the market and there is not. Let me know if I'm missing something that is not like a professional in-clinic peel off mask that lasts a couple of days, not this instant peel off mask. That's not how the skin works. Peels can be expensive though. I've had one done and they can be pricey. They are very effective. So what can you do at home? Well, you could use something like glycolic acid, exfoliating toners. They obviously speed up the skin's renewal process, making dark spots fade quicker. It takes time. It does take time. But you know, as much as we don't like them, they're not something you need to rush to get rid of. We all get them. The majority of us get them. Retinols and retinoids work in pretty much the same way. I do find glycolic acid more effective though, for me personally, probably because I'm here in the UK, we can't quite get the kind of retinoids that you can get in America. Azelaic acid serums and creams have actually been amazing for this as well, for my skin. To put it very, very simply, azelaic acid can target that overactive pigment production. I mean, it only lightens those dark areas and not your whole face. I find azelaic acid works amazing, either in a serum form or a cream. I personally like it in what's it called, the Paula's Choice 10% azelaic acid. Does wonders for me. Even when it comes to redness, I find that it's really helped with my skin. The next one is kind of new. It's like the newest trick, the latest fake skincare result from these kind of profiles. These are the poppy seed blackheads. So this is really gross. It actually makes me feel kind of sick. So as we can see, every one of these videos starts out with someone rubbing cream on a blackheady area. Blackheady, official term, ask any dermatologist. But what these are, at first of all, they're using a filter here that kind of shows up more pores. It's kind of like a high pass kind of effect where it kind of makes everything look a lot more sharpened and shows up everything. Deeper pores, deeper fine lines, shows up all the texture, right? So they're making their skin look more texturized than it actually is, right? But then after a while, look at all this gunk and blackheads that have magically appeared. And they're claiming that this product can literally lift blackheads out of those pores, out of the nose. Hundreds by the looks of it, even where there were no blackheads or pores before. If this was actually blackheads coming up, then you have a massive problem. There should not be that concentration of blackheads within your nose, right? It means not exfoliating, it means not cleansing properly. So these are clearly poppy seeds, maybe even strawberry seeds because they're a bit lighter in color. And I have to be honest, it does look super effective when it's wiped away and on that cotton pads. It does look like they've got a few blackheads on there, but it also makes me want to throw up. Blackheads, if you really have this many blackheads, if this is a problem where that many blackheads are coming out of your skin, you need to go and get a professional extraction. These can be quite expensive because they're usually part of like a larger process. Salicylic acid the go-to for anybody with oily skin, congested looking skin, blackheads. Again, over time with regular use, used roughly 3 times a week, you will start seeing a difference in congested pores, size of your pores, reduction of blackheads, and your pores will begin to look a lot smaller. That's what I found in my case anyway. Obviously don't change size, but because the salicylic acid is oil soluble and can actually penetrate the pore, clearing out from the inside, they look a lot clearer. For me, the best combination has been a BHA in the morning and then a retinol at night, keeping my pores looking fresh and clear. There is no product on the market that just lifts blackheads out like this. Also, they usually don't look like this. They're like long and slightly beige with a black head, like a black tip. And that's why they're called blackheads, because the top is oxidized, making it that dark black color. The whole thing won't be that color. This is just black seeds and it's really horrible. Blurred skin is the next one. This is the most popular and common video I've seen. They apply this cream, wipe it away, then all of a sudden there's no texture on the skin. It's blurry. The whole area is blurred. The pores are blurred. But if you look really, really carefully, you can actually see the fingers doing the cream becoming blurred as well. The video overall is terrible quality as well to kind of help hide this. There is no alternative to this product because who the hell wants skin that looks blurred like that? It's horrible. We need texture. We're human, not aliens. Although generally taking care of your skin is going to help your pores look appear smaller, just give you brighter looking skin, healthier looking skin. Some of my favorite ingredients to make my skin look healthier: BHAs, niacinamide, ceramides, peptides, a good double cleanse, a hydrating toner are all things that I go to in order to improve my skin tone and texture. And of course, sunscreen, most importantly, but also just taking your time with your skincare routine and sticking to your skincare routine. Okay, final one. This is the mole removal with a fancy cotton bud. I don't know why you need like a fancy handheld cotton bud holder. I don't know what this is. The only reason you should be removing a mole is for health reasons. You know, if you've gone to a dermatologist and they say that it could be cancerous, for example. Otherwise, they're fine. Leave them alone. Okay, so as we can see, we have the cream being applied to the mole, a fancy cotton bud rubs over and it's magically gone. Again, obviously this kind of product doesn't exist for you to just go out and buy. At first I was like, they're using a video editor, they're masking the mole with a piece of clear skin. Done. Easy, debunked it. I was like, they're getting really clever and really technical with these videos. But the more I was watching these mole removal videos and the more I kind of saw like a larger selection, let's say, I noticed that they were literally just drawing on the mole with probably like a non-waterproof eyeliner or something. They're just rubbing off. That's it. But there's a real technique to it. There's a real technique to make sure you don't just smudge the fake mole and that it completely comes off. I haven't tried this yet. I'm going to try this after I film this video. I'm not sure how successful I'm going to be, but we'll see. So yes, of course, don't believe everything you see on the internet. There are some videos that are way more convincing than others, but a lot of us know that these are just terrible, terrible lies. I saw one recently where they applied cream to a chin and then put loads of mushed up banana on the chin. And they were like, wow, I use this all the time. It really works. It's like, what the fuck is this supposed to be? So I'm looking forward to what they come up with next. He seems to be getting more and more inventive, not more realistic. Please keep tagging me in these videos over on TikTok, James_S_Welsh. If they make their way onto Instagram as well, tag me over there with the same username. But that is it from me now. I will see you next time.